If you're a pet owner, you'll no doubt do or spend just about anything to keep your dog or cat safe and healthy.
Yeah, but there is a monthly medication that tens of thousands of pet owners, and perhaps some of you, say is making their four-legged family friends sick. Sloan Heller has the story.
Cho likes to lie low. He's only 10 years old, but the last 5 years haven't been easy. The bills and pills piled up after a routine visit to the vet. Cho was getting his second dose of Frontline, a preventative flea and tick treatment. But his owner, Jan Jaffe, says just 48 hours later, her otherwise healthy dog was vomiting and lethargic.
I wondered every day if he was going to make it.
Jaffe spent $10,000 to save Cho, and she's not alone. In Texas, it took $5,000 to save Sassy, and there's been similar stories across the country.
He will probably always have a wobble.
We looked at hundreds of documents, government databases, and court cases to find out what's being done to protect your pet from reacting to a flea and tick product. Companies like Hartz, Advantix, and Frontline sell the products over the counter in shampoo and powder form. But the EPA says it only saw a sharp increase in reported reactions to the spot-on treatment applied directly to the back of a pet. The latest data shows there were 34,800 complaints just in a 16-month period, but not everyone is alarmed.
You take into account the billions and billions of doses of these flea products that are used on there. How big a percentage is 34,000 compared to billions?
Dr. David Kunkel is vice president of the Ohio Veterinarian Medical Association. Kunkel believes spot-on products are safe.
I'd be willing to bet that upwards of 99% of the adverse reactions that are reported, there's actually something else going on in that animal that contributed to its demise. It was just a coincidence that that flea product was used on them.
Here at home, vets at Fairway Animal Hospital also tell us the products are safe.
If you're looking at a high risk of ticks getting on your dog and therefore high risk of disease transmission, it's worth the risk to take that, to apply those medications.
In a letter, Frontline's parent company, Mariel, told Cho and Sassy's owners the symptoms their pets exhibited were not consistent with the use of Frontline.
It seems like our problems, even though they're in the thousands and growing, are sort of minimized.
Pet owners aren't the only ones continuing to fight. The Humane Society of the United States is pushing for change.
I think we're really only scratching the surface as far as the number of actual injuries and deaths that occur because of these products.
The Humane Society wants a national poison control hotline so complaints are processed in a central location. Right now, consumers complain to the manufacturer, and then that information is passed on to the EPA.
Why would the EPA allow the manufacturers to police themselves?
The EPA did not offer a response, but public documents reveal the EPA's own investigation found more detailed data is needed about each adverse reaction. The association, however, still isn't gathering that information, instead focusing on labeling changes, and says current warning labels are hard to read, buried in text, or just not specific. The EPA also says many of those adverse reactions are likely caused by misuse, saying pet owners are using dog products on cats and misdosing the product.
In spite of the labels indicating that they shouldn't be used in cats, people don't often see that and think that they can apply the same medication to their dog and also put a few drops on their cat. And the cats have very serious neurologic toxicity that can occur with certain over-the-counter products.
Sloan Heller, NBC Action News.
Lawyers across the country are filing lawsuits against the makers of many of these spot-on products. We contacted the major companies. They each say that their product is safe and complaints are low. Now, you might recall several years ago, the FDA recalled tainted pet food from China that contained melamine, but the contaminant can still be found in many pet treats sitting on store shelves. Local Vet tells you what to look for tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. on NBC Action News Weekend Today.